Hello. I like to make today a type of music-orientated cake for Taylor Swift sort of fans. What we need for this recipe, first of all, we need to bake two round cakes in round baking tin, which is 20 centimeter each. It's 8 inches, and so we have two of those. And we needed one bake in a 16 centimeter round baking pan, which is about 6 inches. All inches, ounces, everything will be in description box. Please do have a look. So we're using three of vanilla cake mix boxes or packets, and we get three cakes. So what we do is we just use basic vanilla frosting, spread small amount on the middle of a cake board, and place the first cake on top and spread frosting on top of it. Make sure all three cakes are completely cooled down and are flattened. So use a serrated knife to level all three cakes so they are flat, because this makes much easier to assemble and make nice and neat structure. So what we do is we place the last cake right in the middle of the round cake, and we frost all over as well. We just apply a thin layer of frosting to make sure we seal all crumbs. Once apply a thin layer of frosting around entire cake, we place in the freezer for about 30 minutes to seal all crumbs. Next step is to make it microphone, which is we place on top of cake. For microphone, we need purchase basically microphone chocolate mold, and this one I purchased from eBay, and it's a few different varieties up there. Also available on Amazon and Etsy and various other sort of type of similar sites. This one particular is 15 centimeter long. You can purchase any size or shape you like. Good idea place on a small trench. It just makes it easier to transfer into refrigerator, as well as the place couple cookie cutters to make sure it's actually stable and dry. So to make a microphone, we can use the red color candy melts, or use white chocolate melts or white chocolate and tint it with a red basically powder coloring. This one particular design to melt the chocolate. And what we do is, once we melt our chocolate in the microwave on top of saucepan with the simmering water, what we do is next we pour into a mold. Fill out completely, strike and make sure it's dry. Do not get worried if it comes out from the shape of a microphone. Better to be straight, because the straight ones easy to connect together to make it one microphone from two pieces. So once we done that, what we do is we slightly just tap it to remove any bubbles and place into refrigerator to set and harden. By the time when our microphone is set and hardened, what we do is we prepare extra decoration for sides of a cake. So what we do, we use the notes, which is we can print it from internet on any size you like. They can be smaller or larger. So place on a small board, cardboard or plastic board, doesn't really matter, and secure with tape all around to make sure you're able to work without problems. So cut out small pieces of paper, non-stick baking paper, to make sure it's basically we're able to see through. We don't need them big because we transfer them on top of tray to completely set for later. But what you do is use dark chocolate melts and melt them in the microwave on top of saucepan with the simmering water, and place turn a tray on the other side, on the back side, to make sure we're able to slide our papers on top for the setting and hardening. So place your melted dark chocolate into piping bag fitted with tip 3, and what we do is we simply pipe on top of baking paper. Don't make them too thin to make sure they not break well when you want to place them on top of a cake, nice and thick. And what you do is use a toothpick to actually adjust and make shape is more attractive and even. Do not worry about little bits if they a little bit comes out, because so you can remove the ones they already hardened. So what you do is simply transfer onto baking tray and repeat procedure and make as many as you like. Once you've done as many as you want, you can place on a trays. I just look, yep, you can see. So you're able to see that I place on a trays. And what you do is set simply aside on a bench, or if you like, place in a refrigerator to completely set and harden. Once microphone is set, do not invert onto non-stick baking paper. And what we do is we simply take a nice small sharp knife and just go right around to get rid of any excess of chocolate or candy melts, whatever you're using. Make sure it's nice and strong. And as you can see, it's a perfect microphone. So what we do is next, any leftover you can actually reuse, reheat them and reuse them again. So what we do is we just place one side and place leftover of red tinted chocolate or candy melts into a snap lock bag. Make it a little bit flat, make sure it's not any ears, air. And what you do is snip the very end and simply pipe on top to join two pieces. Once you slightly press them together, if it's anything comes out, just simply wipe it. And if you see any gaps, what you do is we just simply use a small amount of the chocolate, just squeeze it in, and what we do, 1, 2, 3, 4, and wipe it. And as you can see, it has nice and straight, very neat texture. So leave it as it is on baking paper to make sure it's completely set and hardened before we decorate microphone. Once microphone is set, place on a plate, and what you do is take a small amount of sugar glue and just brush it on the areas we like to place some black color fondant. Roll a very small amount of black color fondant and just place to decorate microphone. And snip away excess. Next step is we're using or sending sugar or any sugar type of crystals, red sugar crystals, and we use also in any piping gel will do. Will be just a normal average piping or red piping gel. What you do is simply brush all around a microphone sprinkle with a little bit of sugar to make it really, really special. You can use reuse this sugar, whatever it's for, just collect it and reuse it. And just let it set a little bit, this microphone, and we can assemble cake. Once we take from freezer our cake, what we do is we frost second layer of our frosty, nice and thick now. And what we do is to make it just lines for fit our music notes, what we do is use the small skinny, so more like a skinny skewer, and black gel food coloring. Place small amount of black gel food coloring, and with brush, just a little bit brush, no need that much, just a little bit. Once we're done that, what we do is, first of all, we actually do right on the middle, as you can see we're done. Then we divided our two parts into half as well, and we just simply draw right around, wipe it away, place small amount of gel food coloring again, and now we can do on the second part. Put it together. So that's what we got, three lines on each, divided each cake on half, and then each half on half, so we can get sort of symmetrical lining. Now what we do is we attach our music notes. Now we simply attach the our prepared notes in a various order and just simply keep going this way. You can make them higher or lower. If you really, really good with music, you can even print certain only notes and put them even in a kind of a song sort of way if you really, really good. So we just keep going and placing these notes all over cake. Once you position all musical notes around our cake, so we made 30 musical notes in total. It's enough to place on the bottom and on top of our cake. Simply position microphone, ready microphone on top of cake, and it's done. Everything will be in the description box. Please do have a look. If you have any questions, please do ask. I hope you like this sort of cake for music lovers or for fans of Taylor Swift. Thank you very much for your time. Until next time, goodbye.